Hello and welcome to my channel. In my previous tutorials, we have created player animations and the player idle state. In this tutorial, we are going to create the player run state. We can now begin creating our run state for the player, but what we need first is to get some inputs from the player from the keyboard. So what we need to do is go over to our input map, go to project settings and then input map. In new action, let's add the action and we'll call it move left and then add. Click the plus button and then press A on the keyboard. And when it detects that key, click OK. Click add again, but click the left button on the keyboard and add left. So we can use A or the left key to move left. In add action again, type move right. And click add. And the plus button, this time we want to use the D key and click plus again and use the right key. And that's, and click OK. This will then create the inputs from the keyboard for moving left and moving right. Click close. And in your player script, let's create a new function. We'll call this function player run and pass in delta. Now that we've created our input map for moving left and right, we can get the direction from the input. So say var direction equals, and then use the input class, and then get axis. Just use move left and move right. So now that we're getting the direction from the input, the direction will be either 1 or minus 1 depending on if it's moving right or left. So we want to say if direction then velocity, and then because we're moving left and right, we want to affect the x-axis in the velocity, then say direction and then a speed. So for now, I'm just going to use 300. And then we want to say else. And then velocity.x equals, and then we're going to use another built-in method called move toward. And we'll say velocity.x 0 and then 300, which is our speed value. Okay, click save. And then let's run this level. So go back to 2D on your level and click run. Now press D and nothing is currently happening. So the reason why nothing is happening is because in my script I've not added my player run to my physics process function. So I want that to be called as well. So as physics process is called, it will go through play falling, then idle, and then run. So save that. Let's run that again. And let's see what we get. Okay, so it's now moving left and right. Stop that. So what we could see is as we were moving left and right, there was no animation. We want to go from the idle animation, and when we're in run, run the running animation. So let's create another function to call our animation. So we'll go function player animation. I'll call it animations. And then we want to say if my current state equals state idle, then get the animated sprite and call play for the idle animation. Now there's a way to get these nodes in your script. So click the node that you want. Click with the left mouse button and drag into the window, but hold down the control key now before you release the left button. So now release the left button and it will create an onReady variable, which means at the beginning when the player comes into view, it will already instantiate and have a reference to this item here. So what I can now do is we can copy that, pop that into our current state here, and then call the player function. And if I'm in current state idle, I want to run idle. Now, what we want to then do is say else if my current state is running or in run state. Run. Then let's copy this and call run. Okay. Now call the play animation after move and slide. Yeah. So as the physics process goes through, it will evaluate what state I'm in and then move the player and then play the animation. What we are missing though is that we don't set the run animation anywhere. So what we can do here is go back to the player run method and then say if my direction, if it's not equal to zero, then I want to set my current state equals my run state. Okay. Let's head over back to level and let's play and let's use our key. So now we've got running animations. So this is going, so when we go right, but when we go left, the sprite isn't facing the right way. So there is an easy fix for this. Let's just stop that. Go back to your player run method and grab the animated 2D sprite. And on the property flip H, we want to use a ternary method, so we'll say false if my direction is greater than zero, else true. This is known as a ternary statement, and it's the if statement all on one line. So we're saying if the direction is greater than zero, is false, and then set that to true. And that will be assigned to flip H. Let's run that game again. Okay, going right and then going left, and that's our running animation. Let's stop that. Head back over to the script and let's just improve this variable here. So we'll do another constant variable and we'll call that speed and we'll put 300 here. We'll just copy and paste that in there. Let's save that. Let's just do a quick test again. Let's run the game. And there we go, that's fine. Let's run the game one more time. Okay, let's make some modifications and change the window size and the viewport size. So let's just shut that down and then go to project settings, find window, and in the viewport width, change this to 640 and then 360 here. And then in mode, we want to choose viewport. And then we need to go to our advanced settings and in the width override, so we can say 640 and make that double the size and then double the size for the height as well. And we can then close those settings. So if we run the game again, well, as you can see, our viewport is set to 640 by 360, but this editor window is double that size. So this gives us a good viewport and window size whilst we build the game. Now that brings us to the end of this tutorial. If you like what you've seen, please remember to click like and subscribe. In my upcoming tutorials, I will continue making components for a 2D platforming game. These will be enemies, game menus, and collectibles. So come along and check them out. Thank you for watching.